If you are new here, I'm Ganiti, and if you're already watching this channel, welcome back. Today we are watching episode 26 of Golden Wind JoJo Bizarre Adventure. So let's get to it. Let's go. Okay, a little story from the past. My name is Doppio. 1965. Prisoner. Well, are they so shocked that she's pregnant? She had a huge belly, right? 2 to 10 years and she's been doing time for... Well, really? So it's just so super sudden? So, she was holding it in 2 years? Pink hair, ha ha ha. And honey eyes. Wait. What year it is right now? The boy. So... Oh, that's sweet. Yeah, and that's Trish's mom. So that's her dad. Well, the frog is pretty. He had freckles. And he did have pink hair. And he seems like a nice person. He was worried about a frog. That's cute. That's exactly the place where that photo was taken? Wait, who's this guy? The priest. What the heck? What the heck? Is she alive? What is going on? How did this even happen? And what? And who is the dad's dad? He killed his mom? But why? And how did she stay alive? What did he do this for? faked his own death. Present. That's it? I need some time to take this in. But he does have pink hair after all. In the silhouette, it looked like. What? Wasn't it present day? Wait. He looks super young. They were green for a second. If you want it so much, maybe I don't have to pay. If it's really hot dad, why does he look so young and his hair looked different in the silhouette? Okay. Your daughter, so yes. Yeah, that's what I thought. Even his voice changed. There's something strange about him. That's true. Now they are green. I remember he had green eyes. Now the voice is right too. He can appear younger. But what he did to his mom was also strange. And it doesn't seem to work with his ability that we know. Yes. Okay. So he wants to go for risotto first? This guy is very talented though. How? That's pretty cool. And he's not a stand user, he just has talent. This makes sense. So he does have two personalities. And also, when he's appearing young, he has a nice personality. I think he went kind of insane. The boy saw it. That's interesting. He changed his personality again? Does he have some limits? Like, he didn't kill that woman that was cleaning the apartment, and he didn't touch the kid. Oh, risotto is here. Is it because his personality changes, or he has some limits in who he is ready to kill? For example, he does love insects and animals. That's cool. That's nice. His voice is different. His eye color is different. This is where the photo was taken. So there's also some mystery regarding his birth. He was held for 2 years and he was born in a strange way. And I wonder if it's important who his father is. Yeah, he's trying to rip off a tourist. It's probably with a photo. Ew, I don't want to see it. So normally he is this nice young personality, but when he's... How is his eye alright? But when he gets like in danger... He's the one who makes the sound? Dude, you're right. He imagines that his older personality is his boss, or he didn't. Maybe the child that was born was possessed by the second personality. But how Risotto got on his trail? Ah, so he just came to this place. Right. And waiting for Trish to arrive, I guess. So there really are like to different people living in his body, not even two shades of same personality. But I wonder if there are two people, could there be two stand abilities? One that is of King Crimson and one that allowed him to do whatever he did with his mother and stay in young bodies? There are a lot of options, I guess. We need more clues. What? If his name is Doppel, does it mean the older personality's name is different? So his head hurting is a sign for personality changing. He wants to go for the envelope. Now I'm worried for Risotto. I like his design and his voice sounds cool. Because he doesn't have murderous intent. The other personality does. He managed to hide it? Under his boot. Ira Smith? He recognized it. He knows. Such an important location. Maybe I'm just a tourist walking around. He's very perceptive. He's saying everything right. That's why he was counting the distance. He uses something? This again! Yeah, he was using things like knives and other stuff. Now it's razor blades. But if he does kill him, then what? Shouldn't be possible. He wouldn't lose one of his personalities like this. His hitman ability. Yeah, they all have this ability. So the calling is for him to talk to his other side. What's go? Oh, the frog! Oh, poor froggy! Oh. Hmm. So there's only King Crimson. He doesn't have any additional ability. To sum it up, so there was a woman in the prison who was with some guy 2 years prior to boss's birth. Let's call him Doppio, all right? But first of all, she held this baby for 2 years, and as from the god's conversation, it seems like it was super sudden. So there wasn't like barely slowly growing or anything. Like he was just waiting for the right moment, I'm not sure. And then what? She was released from the prison. And then she knew something about him that he didn't want her to tell anyone. So he didn't kill her for some reason, but just sew her mouth and hit her under the floorboards. Even though then he killed the. Like, first of all, if he didn't want to kill her because she's his mother, he only did worse. It would be more of a mercy to kill her than what he did in the end, right? And then he had no qualms about killing the priest and setting everything on fire. So this is a bit strange. And how was she able to stay alive like that? That's pretty crazy. That's what gave me the thought that maybe there's some kind of additional ability, but maybe that's just some kind of oddity, like this fortune teller guy. He doesn't have a stand or anything, but he has these special abilities. So we should also account for that. That people can be odd in some ways, which isn't provided by a stand ability, but just their own nature, so to say. So then this baby was born as a very strange baby. He had these honey eyes, but yeah, as we saw both, he had green eyes as we first saw his silhouette. And yeah, he didn't cry when he was born. I'm not sure how important this is, but the thing is, somehow there is some mystery involving his birth. Maybe his father was somehow odd, weird in some way. There has to be some kind of reason, right? Because his mom, other than the fact that she stayed alive like this, other than that, she seems like a normal woman. And then we don't know anything about his dad. But there has to be some reason why this happened to him, or why he has two personalities living in his body. It basically seems like there was this boy, Doppio, that was born. And he is a nice, kind boy, a bit silly, a bit nervous and clumsy. He likes animals and insects and all of that. He is gentle. He is maybe easily scared. So these are all the qualities that we seem to see in him. But then in his body, so to say, there's another entity living. And then we also have to account for all the years that have passed. Doppio should be old right now. So can we assume that somehow he's not aging in this Doppio form? When he's Doppio, he's just stuck at a particular age. And then the other side of him, that is the boss, this is the side that is actually growing and aging, because when he did change into a boss, so to say, his physique changed and his age also changed. There wasn't like much shown to us, but we could see the reaction of a fortune teller guy. So It basically seems like, and his hair color is changing and his head hurts. So it's basically like, not like him having two personalities, but actually another person living inside of him. But then looks like there's only one stand for the two of them, at least so far it seems like it. Doppio doesn't have his own stand, so to say. And yeah, since he has to connect somehow to this other personality, other person living inside of him, he imagines like there's a phone call that he has to answer, and that's how he talks to himself. It does seem crazy from the side for sure. I'm pretty poor driver, he was pretty scared. But yeah. And when he goes in the range where he can kill another person, or when he feels secure, the boss can come out. So I can assume that boss can take over at any time he wants and for as long as he wants. But he just chooses to stay as Doppio most of the time, because people will probably think that he's just a civilian, like Risotto fought for a second, and also he's too young, so nobody will assume that he is the boss. I'm happy that he has pink hair, because I was thinking, like, if Trish has pink hair and we already saw her mom with kind of brown hair, then her dad has to have pink hair. But then in his silhouette, in boss's silhouette, also he had a different hairstyle and it didn't seem pink. But I think here with fortune teller, when he changed, he still had pink hair. So maybe just in silhouette, it wasn't clear. Yeah, I'm really happy that he has pink hair. That's really cool. I like pink hair. That's cute. Did I want to say anything else? I think I mentioned most of it. I really like Risotto's style. Risotto looks so cool. His ability is also interesting. Looks like he can create dangerous small metal objects at any place that he wants. That's all I can assume from what I've seen. His voice also sounds cool, and on the topic of voice, it's pretty cool how Doppio and Boss also have different voices, so different eye color, different voice, different physique, different age, maybe also different hair color, really. Basically a different person. So that's just perfect if you want to hide yourself, that you are able to appear as someone who doesn't look like you. Yeah, that's probably what I wanted to say. And also we saw that our guys are already somewhere nearby, because Narancia is scouting the location, looking for something, probably. Maybe Trish already remembered about the photo, and they're already looking for this location, because she can't remember. She can't know where it was exactly. She only saw it in the photo. She wasn't there. So yeah, that's pretty interesting. And also, Trish is actually the daughter of Doppio and not of the boss. If I see them as two separate entities, it was Doppio who was going out with her mother. He was in this Doppio identity at that point. So that's pretty interesting. And usually, yeah, that's how he appears in this sweet personality that I really like. And his design, his hairstyle, everything looks pretty cute. I hope the frog he used for the phone will be alright, especially since he also likes little creatures. And I would hate for him to see something bad happen to a frog. I'm sure it would traumatize poor Doppio. If I'm right and this personality could actually be saved, something else. Giorno also cares for the life of living creatures and he can also create it. So that's an interesting link we can find between Doppio and Jorn. That's also something I wanted to mention. Okay, there's really a lot that can be said about this. I don't have enough clues to speculate too much about how all of this works, but that's just, I think, my conclusions for now. Of course, you don't have to explain it to me. I'm sure more clues will be given in future episodes, but share your thoughts on this particular episode, without spoilers of course, in the comments down below. That would be it for today. Thank you for watching and see ya!